Hey everyone, today I want to review, build, and launch this binder design rocket called the Excel. It's a 3-inch diameter rocket, and I'm going to fly it on a G sugar motor. So let's take a look at the quality of those parts and get started assembly. The first thing I noticed when I opened the kit was that things are individually packaged here. I like this concept. It makes it easy to determine if you have everything in your kit that you're supposed to have and that you have everything that you need. For instance, I can see I have the rail buttons here. I have some sort of motor retention here. A really cool looking parachute. Can't wait to check that out. And so the first thing I always do when I get a kit is open it up and make sure that everything that I'm supposed to have is in there. That way, if I'm short something or something's not quite right, I can contact the manufacturer and get that resolved. Now, I want to talk about that for just a second. What happens if you get a kit and something's wrong, something's missing? You order a 4-fin rocket and you get 3 fins or whatever. Now, I don't think there's anything missing in this kit. I'm not saying there is, but the first thing that you want to do is contact the manufacturer and let them try to resolve the situation. I have found that manufacturers are more than willing to bend over backwards and make sure that you're happy with your kit and you have everything you need. So give them a chance to do it. Don't go on social media and say, hey man, don't order from them, they suck, or anything like that. Just let them resolve the issue. And don't put it away for 4 years and come back and find out that something's not quite right. That's not fair to them either. Okay, enough with the rant. Let's open this up and take a look at what these parts look like. The kit comes with 12 feet of shock cord here, plenty enough for this rocket. I don't see any reason to change this. Occasionally, this is a part that I will update, but this is more than sufficient for this rocket. A lot of effort has been put into the instruction manual here. There's a number of pages. It even tells you how to tie this fancy knot here. I'm sure it has a name. I don't know what it is, but very well done. And then you get to the back of it, and there's a fin guide there, too, to assist in the assembly. Now the fins, it says in the manual that they're 3/16 of an inch, but I measured it as 1/4 of an inch. That's not a problem. It's just that maybe that's what they had on hand. I'm not sure, but there's plenty of plies here. This is going to be super strong for those hard landings that occasionally occur. And there's plywood centering rings and all the hardware that I showed you earlier. So let's put some of these parts together. Oh yeah, and check out the parachute. Man, this is really nice, nice and bright. Heavy duty 24-inch parachute. So yeah, I like that, easy to see. Before you install the fin can, make sure that the shock cord is tied on securely, that you have some epoxy on the bottom of the nut there so that it doesn't come loose. And also you wanna make sure that you have your rail buttons installed. And this unit comes with a motor retainer that I don't have on yet. But I'm going to put that on and we can go ahead and finish assembling the rest of the rocket. You'll notice that I put a T on the top of the fins there, and that's to show me that that's the correct orientation. Last thing you want to do is find out that you've installed them on upside down or backwards or something. And well, if you do that, it becomes a builder's option, right? It's just another design feature. Okay, I'm about ready to install this. I'll put the motor retainer in and we'll be all set to go. Well, this turned out to be a fun build. We have motor retention here and super sturdy fins, nice graphics that cover both sides of the fins. It just looks really sharp. The nose cone I painted with a Rust-Oleum orange color. It comes in black, but I used white primer on it to give it that deep color and then just painted it with the orange. I think it turned out pretty nice, although it probably would look good with black just as well. I like the 3-inch models because they are economical to fly, and you can just fly them on smaller fields, and they just fit really well in the lineup for me, at least. So the next thing to do is put this on the launch rail and see how it flies.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
If you enjoyed this video, give me a thumbs up. And I always like to hear from my subscribers, so leave me a comment in the comment section. And until then, blue skies, I'll see you soon. If you enjoyed this video, give me a thumbs up. And I always like to hear from my subscribers, so leave me a comment in the comment section. And until then, blue skies, I'll see you soon.